Hi everyone, happy Easter. I hope you have a great and safe Easter. Welcome to Be Smart Together. I am your bunny, KT. Today, I will show you how to create dynamic expand the merge columns in Power Query. Before we begin, please click subscribe and turn on the notification to avoid missing valuable videos. Also, feel free to drop a comment or throw me any Excel challenges, and I will show you the best way to deal with them in future videos. We have the sales data and the lookup table, city list. So let's quickly merge the city list to the sales data in Power Query Editor, and I will show you the challenges with Power Query at expanding data. When we are trying to expand the data, we manually select the columns we want to merge into the existing dataset. What if users add a new column to the lookup table? Let me show you what happens after we add a new column. Add a new column and name it first character. Type in the first character of the suburb and cell D2, then hit enter. Hold Ctrl plus E for quick populate from the previous example. Overwrite the Battersman's B with B, then hit enter. Let's go to the Sheet 3 tab and refresh the table. Unfortunately, the newly added column didn't flow into this table. Let's go to the Power Query Editor and edit the sales data query. Usually, we would click on the step to add the newly added column. Click Cancel. Pay attention. I will show you how to make it dynamically add the newly added column. We want to overwrite the highlighted formula. Let me explain to you a little about the new formula. Table.ColumnNames will return you the column name in the table as a list of text. Now you have the four columns returned from the lookup table. However, we previously loaded it in Excel with the city_list.prefix. We need to apply the list.transform formula to add the prefix. So here you go, the prefix has now been added. List.transform formula returns you a new list by transforming the existing list. The underscore symbol represents each row in the list. Looks, how good is that? We previously excluded the suburb column and are now included. So, we need to exclude the suburb column. How do we exclude it in this case? We need to add the list.select formula to the highlighted formula. This formula replaces the highlighted formula, which is translating that returns a list of text that does not contain suburb. Hit enter once you have updated the formula. The suburb column has now been excluded. Let's load it in Excel. It looks great. Let's test it. Go to the city list tab and add a test column. Then, come back to sheet 3 and refresh the table. The test column automatically flows in the table. Let's delete some columns from the lookup table this time. Then, refresh the table. Boom! How great it is! I hope today's topic helps, and the workbook and Power Query formula I used in this video is attached to this post. Thank you for watching, and I hope you find this video helpful. Please don't forget to click like if you like the video.